Hi, I'm Dave Balkan, a Balkan Sewer and Water Main Service. I want to give a little tutorial that's going to tout the Milwaukee M18 cordless electric pipe threader. I have no association with the company. It's just a tool that I'm very fond of. This is a piece of 3/4-inch iron pipe that's been cut. It's been reamed. It's ready to be threaded. Now, you can use a hand threading tool. Regardless if you use the hand threading tool or the cordless, a big key to have a long-lasting tool is to apply plenty of oil, because heat does build up. If you don't oil it through the whole threading process, you will burn out the teeth. Now, to hand thread this piece of pipe, it only takes a few minutes, but it also takes some energy. So it's going to vary by the individual. How much is your time worth? How much energy do you want to spend threading pipe? Because this can be a bit of a job, right? Contrary to spending that kind of time and energy, again, it's not an inexpensive tool. It's somewhere around $1,800. But again, it comes down to how much is your time worth? You have to do the math. I can't do that for you. But it's a super simple tool. Now, regardless of which tool you use, on 3/4-inch pipe, you know, it's open to debate how many threads are ideal. I've been told 8 to 9 threads. I kind of prefer 8 threads because my projects seem to sock up really well when you just put in 8 threads. The fitting is really made to accommodate 8 or 9 threads. Putting more threads doesn't have a benefit, and putting less threads means it really won't sock up properly. So how this tool works is this item gets screwed on. If you had a call, if this was a clock, you'd say you tighten it at about 2 o'clock, okay? This is what the Milwaukee M18 will be supported by. First thing you do is oil. You also have a drop bucket underneath, because if you want to be professional, you do not want to leave metal shavings all over your house or a client's house. So this gets hung on the bar. Pipe gets placed in the center. The setting for 3/4 iron pipe, it's either a 1 or a 2. It's a 2. I'm going to thread it, start the threading process. Approximately every turn, I'm going to oil it, because you don't want to overheat the threads. You'll ruin the head on the machine. And a complete new head is about $130, which is a hell of a lot more than cutting wood. That's about two turns. Maybe I went too far. I'm going to put oil. Go another turn or two, put oil. Go another turn or two, put oil. Now, how I know when to stop is I want to put it about 1 usable thread past the outer edge of the heads inside of this tool. That will give me about 8 usable threads. And the key is usable threads, and that's my opinion. I'm just checking how many threads am I past the head. 1. That's where I stop. I'm going to hit this button that reverses it. My battery went dead. All right, so now, reverse the button, reverse the direction. Tool is off. Take an object, thin object. You'll push it through to clean out the shavings into a drop bucket. That's ideal. Again, not on your customer's floor, not on your floor. What you want to do is take a rag, wipe off the oil, and you have a perfect pipe thread with virtually no manual labor at all. There you go. And if you count the threads, you want to count the valleys of usable threads between 8 and 9, you're going to have a perfect fit every time. And I hope that helped you out there. Thank you.